Let's move on to chapter 9 on page 130 and 131. We know that our body is a complex living organism. There are different activities which are done by us: running, walking, teaching, listening. For these all activities, we need energy. So how do we get energy? This energy we get from the food which we eat. Such kind of energy we obtained in the process of respiration. Now let us go deep into the process of respiration. Do you know when we go, why do we go for morning walk or jogging in the morning? This is all because the quantity of morning air is cleaner and richer in oxygen. This fills us when we do this such a sort of exercise or morning walk. This inhaling air refreshes us and give energetic to our body. We might have absorbed when we walk. After walking a long distance, we will have a very long breath because our body need more oxygen. This oxygen from where do we get? From the lungs. The inhaling air through the respiratory tract, it reaches the lungs. And the blood carries this oxygen to every part of the cells. Every part of our cell do respiration. There is a difference between breathing and respiration. Breathing is a physical activity, whereas cellular respiration is a chemical activity. Breathing is nothing but only inhaling of air, which is rich in oxygen, and exhaling the air, which is rich in carbon dioxide, through the nose. Breathing is called inhalation, breathing out is called exhalation. Then what about cellular respiration? It is a process of breaking down of food by using the oxygen which we inhale in. Such a respiration chemical activity which takes place inside the body cells. We know that mitochondria is an organism, organelles which is present inside of every cell, which is a function of doing respiration, which perform the respiration process. This mitochondria brings this oxygen and food and breaking this all activity, burning of food with oxygen. It takes place in the mitochondria. Mitochondria breaks this food with the help of oxygen and release energy, which is stored in the process of in the long molecules called ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. It is a big molecule, biomolecules, in which energy is stored. This energy is used for every organelles for their own chemical activities or metabolic activity of cells. Next, we are moving to three basic requirements for respiration. What are three basic requirements which are required for respiration? That is, respiratory system involves transporting medium and organic food. What is respiratory system? Air from the environment which enters into the body of the organism, and carbon dioxide is an end product during respiration which is removed from the body, which is thrown out from the body through the nose. Next comes transporting medium. Blood is a component. Blood is a kind of tissue which is present in our body, which carries oxygen from the lungs and it carries to every cell of the body. Next comes organic food. That is a chemical breaking down of food in the cells and liberate energy. I told you, mitochondria is an organelle which is present inside the cell, which helps to break down the food with the help of oxygen to release energy. Such energy help us to do work, help us to dance, help us to walk, etc. Now let us list out the differences between breathing and respiration. Breathing is a physical process, respiration is a chemical process. And the second point, it takes place through the nose, and respiration takes place in all the living cell, inside the cell. Third point is, breathing involves only exchanging of gas, no formation of new product. Whereas respiration involves chemical reaction in which glucose, which is present in the food, is oxidized with the help of oxygen and release carbon dioxide, water and energy. The final step is energy is consumed and no enzyme is involved in breathing process, and in respiration energy is released and several respiratory enzymes are involved. Now we are moving on to the next topic, the rate of breathing. What is rate of breathing? That is nothing but the number of times a person breathes per minute. One breathing involves one inhalation and one exhalation. So per minute, how many times we are doing breathe? That gives the breathing rate. The rate of breathing varies based on our activity. If we run or if you play, our breathing rate will be increased because so that our body needs more oxygen that will be satisfied by this breathing process. But breathing rate is 4 to 5 times lower than the heartbeat. When we are at rest, our breathing rate will be very less. We can see the different breathing rate based on different age limit. A newborn baby can breathe 50 to 60 times a minute, whereas a 4-year-old child will breathe 25 times a minute. And an adult will breathe only 12 to 18 times a minute. For a newborn baby, the natural chemical substance called surfactant, which helps the alveoli to inflate, or by giving simple pat on it, the baby's back, the baby starts crying because of this breathing movement. That is this first breathing movement which inflates its lungs. As I told you, when we start doing exercise, our breathing becomes much faster and the rate of breathing will be increased almost 15 to 60 times per minute in order to get more oxygen into the body. At the same time, our heart starts to beat faster. This pushes the blood through the heart faster, allowing it to carry oxygen to every cell of our body. Because blood is the only tissue which carries oxygen to every body part or to every body cell. That is what our heart pumps very fast. When we need more oxygen for our body, the heart pumps blood more fast so that blood carries this oxygen and reaches the particular site of the body cells. Now you are going to take the breathing rate of 2 persons. First person is sleeping mode and the second person is doing some physical exercises. So tell me whose breathing rate will be more. Definitely the person who is doing the physical exercises. Because the second person requires more energy. So by breathing, by this physical activity of breathing, oxygen-rich inhaled air will reach the lungs so that the blood carries this oxygen to every part of our body cell for the respiration to occur.